In the early 1960s, legendary Viking coach and athletic director Bob Sullivan created the Marysville Relays, a track and field event that showcased the top athletic talent from around the state of Michigan. The event was a two-day meet held in Marysville City Park. In 1979, another legendary coach and athletic director, Walt Braun, changed the format slightly and began the Marysville Invitational Track Meet. The purpose was refined to highlighting the best track stars from the Blue Water area. This year marks the 40th anniversary of the Marysville Invitational. Viking boys head coach Steve Rogers tells us how many schools were represented at this year's meet and how our two teams fare.
This year was the 40th annual Marysville Invitational. There were 14 teams present. On the girls' side, our girls won it. It was pretty exciting for them. They won the Navy division. And on the boys' side, we were runner-up.
Why has this meet been so popular for so long to other schools?
Two reasons. First one, it's an all-area type meet setting. A lot of meets happen from other local schools, but they have a lot of outside teams. This one is usually set aside just for the local areas in the Blue Water area. And secondly, it is a dress rehearsal to the regionals, which is going to happen the following week.
I understand you implemented a new piece of technology for this year's meet. Can you explain more about the new timing system?
Sure. The timing system that we now have is called a FAT timer, which means fully automated timing system. And what it does is it links to the starter, and he has a mechanism attached to his pistol. So when he fires the pistol, the computer will receive the signal and get a much more accurate time than, say, hand times that we've done in the past. It allows us also to speed up the meet and have less rounds and make the meet go faster.
How does this help the student athletes continue to improve and reach their goals?
Well, with the technology behind it, we can quickly put things online, and kids can document their stuff and recognize whether they're getting better or where they need to improve on when they have this at their fingertips as far as they have internet.
Technology continues to integrate to every facet of our lives, including athletics. What other areas in track have seemed to evolve with the new help of technology?
Well, you can look at the shoes. The shoes are made of much more lightweight material, and they have much more purposeful designs behind them. The clothing that they wear is allowed the kids to breathe more. When they sweat, it breathes a lot easier, so they're not weighed down as much. And we also use phones a lot when in the course of our coaching, whether they watch the kids that don't run their event or do a field event, then we can coach them by showing video of them.
How does the remainder of your season look?
Well, this week, Friday, we head to Clio for our regionals, and that's the biggest meet of our season because that is the ticket to go to the state finals, which will happen on June 1st. And then we finish up with our division meet the following Tuesday, and then we have an all-area Blue Water meet of champions on the 24th of May.
One of the Viking student athletes participating in this year's meet was senior James Sargent. James shared what events he participated in and how long he has been in the track program.
In track, I run the 110-meter hurdles, the 300 hurdles, and I throw shot put. I've been running track since 7th grade, all 4 years in high school, and 7th and 8th grade.
James, you have participated in several sports at Marysville High School. What is your favorite part of track, and especially the big meets?
My favorite part about track is the fact that I get in shape, and I mean, I also like being around all the people. I enjoy all the friends I've made. The big events are a lot of fun because you get to see everybody from other schools and all your friends and, you know, stuff like that, and it's just more competition for you.
As the season winds down, James, what are some of the personal goals you would like to meet?
Personal goals? For the 110 hurdles, I'd like to get under 16 seconds before the season ends. Shot put, I'd like to throw 45 feet, and that could take me to states, potentially. And then for the 300 hurdles, I'd like to get around 43 seconds, knock some time off my times.
Whether a relay or an invitational, the Marysville track meet is always a huge favorite of athletes and fans throughout the area. Thank you, Coach Rogers and James Sargent, for sharing some insights about the season. We wish you the best of luck as you continue to reach for your team and personal goals. I'm Parker Foster, and this has been Viking Sports Weekly on M6, your hometown station.